On Commitment 2010 tonight, I'm Jessica Schambach alongside Paul Folger. We are closely watching the governor's race.
That's right. Let's talk about the Republican side. Mary Fallon being claimed the winner on this, 58% of the votes over Randy Brogdon's 36% of the votes. Mary Fallon takes this one.
And Matt Garcia is standing by live right now at her watch party. Matt, it must be a pretty good mood in there right now.
That's right, Jessica. Just moments ago, the campaign manager announced to the supporters here that the Associated Press declared Mary Fallon the winner. A lot of excitement. With me here is Ed Goas, the chief strategist for the campaign. And Ed, does Mary Fallon even know that AP has called her the winner? She's on a jet right now headed to Oklahoma City.
That's the unfortunate part here. She's going to land in about 20 minutes from what we understand, and we have not been able to get in touch with her, so she does not know the results. She was in the air before the polls closed, and she's going to find out in about 20 minutes. Yeah, she'll be the last one to know.
She expected to land about 9:30. Did you expect it to be this soon?
We thought we were going to have a good solid margin just because Mary is such a strong campaigner out there and gets such a strong response from the voters. We didn't know that they'd call it this early, and I think unfortunately for Mary, they did.
Oh, very good. Well, Ed, congratulations. Congratulations to Mary Fallon as she is called the early winner by the Associated Press. Now all eyes turn to November for this campaign. Paul and Jessica, let's send it back to you.
Okay, Matt, thank you very much. And we also want to talk a little bit about the Democrat side on this. We've got Jerry Askins and Drew Edmondson here. Jerry Askins at 52%, Drew Edmondson at 48%.
It is a close race, and we have reporters standing by at both of their watch parties tonight. Let's start off with Mark Opgrant at Jerry Askins' watch party, and I bet people are closely watching these numbers right now, Mark.
Absolutely. In fact, just a second ago, you see a cheer go up when those numbers start going back in because Askins, as you said, has that slight lead with those precincts reporting right now. But a lot of cautious optimism here. They both feel it's going to be a long night out here as people gather and get ready. I mean, you can tell a lot of people have kind of started to show up here. So as things are starting to get lively. Now, Jerry Askins right now, she's upstairs. She's watching those results come back in. So since it's so close, it'll probably be a while before she gets down here. She's going to be hanging out up there. But again, we'll be here all night and keep you updated as this goes along. We're live. Mark Opgrant, Eyewitness News 5.
Okay, Mark, thank you very much. Of course, this could be the first time we have two women running for governor if Jerry Askins wins this part of the nomination. We've got Wendell Edwards over at Drew Edmondson's side of this campaign as well.
Well, Paul, the supporters here are anticipating a long night as well. They're kind of surprised that Mr. Edmondson is behind at this point, but they, too, are optimistic, and they're watching those numbers closely. I can tell you they changed the name of this party from a watch party to a victory party. That's how confident they are, guys. Back to you.
Okay, we'll be watching it all. Wendell, thank you, and you can watch it alongside with us. Head over to KOCO.com for live election results and stay right here